Good morning. I'm Dr. Mansha. I'm your anesthetist of the day. I will be performing a routine airway examination as a part of the pre-anesthetic checkup. I will be explaining all the tests to you before the test and as we go along the examination. If you face any problems, please let me know. So now we start the examination of the airway with taking all the proper precautions for COVID-19. We start the examination. We ask the patient to remove the mask. Starting with the inspection, we inspect the anatomy of the face. We start from the nose. There appears to be no obvious or deformity of the nasal septum. It appears to be normal. There is no swelling or any bony deformity seen. The mouth appears to be normal. There is no overbite seen. There is presence of facial hair, which can lead to difficult mask ventilation. The jaw appears normal bilaterally. There is no swelling seen, no bony deformity, no retraction or protrusion of the jaw is seen. Now we examine the neck. We examine the neck for any burns, any scar mark, any swelling, any other obvious deformity. Also, we examine the patient from the side to see any deformity present, any swelling present. Then we examine the back of the patient to see any presence of pad of fat, which makes movement of the neck difficult. In female patients, we examine the presence of large breast and thyroid swellings, which make the movement of the neck difficult. We first check for the patency of the nostril. We'll explain the patient the steps how to perform the test. Please inspire first. Take in a deep breath. Close one of your nostril and you have to exhale from the other nostril. And we'll do this first for the left nostril and then for the right nostril. Take a deep breath. Close the right nostril and blow from the left one. The same steps you have to repeat for the right nostril. Take a deep breath and close the left nostril. Now exhale. We will check for the movement of the cotton wick and we will also ask the patient in which nostril he felt better exhalation.
Right nostril
was better. So fine. With this test we check for the patency of bilateral nostrils and we also ask the patient which nostril he felt better. Now next, coming to the examination of the mouth, we ask the patient to open his mouth as wide as he can and stick out the tongue and he doesn't have to say ah. Please open your mouth and stick out your tongue as wide as you can. You don't have to say anything, you don't have to say ah also. Fine. With this, we can inspect the inside of the mouth, the size of the tongue, the dental status, the Malampati score, any deformities present inside the mouth. Please check for the size of the mouth, short mouth or big mouth, and for the presence of high arched palate. Next, we ask the patient to open his mouth and place three fingers inside his mouth and we examine the incisor gap. Please open your mouth and place three fingers like this vertically in the mouth. Okay. Now we ask the patient to close his mouth gently. Please close your mouth and show us your teeth. We do this to check for the dental status and to see if any overbite is present. Now we ask the patient to bite the upper lip with the lower jaw to look for the upper lip bite test. Can you please bite your upper lip with the lower jaw? Okay. We check for the placement of the lower jaw at the vermilion of the lip, that is the upper lip border. If the patient is place the lower jaw above the vermilion, that means that the upper lip bite test is normal, as in this case. Now we ask the patient to look down and bend his rest his chin on the chest. Can you please look down and rest your chin on the chest? We do this to see for the neck mobility, head and neck mobility. Now please extend your neck and look backwards. We do this to see the neck extension. So now we do the Delenkin's test, which is to see the neck extension and neck mobility. In this test, we place the left index finger on the jaw of the patient, that is the lower level of the chin of the patient and the right index finger on the occipital tuberosity of the patient. And we ask the patient to look at the back of the ceiling with the most possible extension of his neck without raising his eyebrows. And we see for the degree of neck extension. Look back at the ceiling as far as possible without raising your eyebrows. Now in this test, we see for the level of the left index finger as compared to the right one. If it is higher up than the right, the left finger is higher than the right, it means that the neck has a good extension. Okay. Now we come to the measurements. In the measurements, we will be doing three distances, that is the thyromental distance, hyomental distance, and the sternomental distance. Also, we will be measuring the neck circumference. Coming to the first distance, for these distances, we command the patient to look back as far as possible and keep the neck in an extended position. And we locate the landmarks, which are mostly the mentum, that is the chin, the thyroid notch, the hyoid bone, and the sternal notch. The first distance is thyromental distance. Please look backwards, that is up in, on the ceiling. Keep your neck in this position only. I will be measuring some distances. This is the mentum. From the Adam's apple, we can locate for the thyroid notch. This distance comes out to be 6.5 centimeters. Which is normal. Then the hyomental distance. This comes out to be 5.5 centimeters. Now we measure the sternomental distance. We keep the lower edge of the scale of the sternal notch and the upper end should come at the mentum. Since this is not reaching the mentum, that means that the distance is more than 12.5 centimeters. Thank you. Next measurement is neck circumference. For this, we ask the patient to keep his neck in the normal resting position and we measure the distance in centimeters at the level of the Adam's apple.